Hello, this is my first recording ever, and I wanted to do why women are called hoes and men aren't, because I've looked it up and I've tried to see a lot of things and people's answers, and I never see what I feel. And I personally don't mind what people choose to do with their bodies. I wish people wouldn't do it as much. I don't know. But my opinion is that as a society, we respect people who do difficult things. You know, no one praised Hercules if everything he did was easy to everybody. If you do something that's easy to everybody else, no one cares. It's not very important. You know, no one really respects you for doing the same thing that everybody else can do, even if you can do it just a little bit better. It's not as special as if you did something that no one else can do, or did something that stands out from everybody else. That's what, you know, we want diamonds. We don't want the same gemstone that everybody else has. It's not as special. You know, that's why people pay more money for things. That's why people wait longer for things. And the reason I believe that women are hoes is that same reason, because women can get sex almost as much as they want to. You know, all a woman has to do is spread her legs, and there's probably a guy who will come and have sex with her. And the same thing with a man not being called a hoe, because it's not that easy. There are plenty of men who have the problem of finding somebody who's going to sleep with them, or somebody to marry that's decent. You know, it's more difficult for a guy to get laid by a bunch of girls. If a girl wanted to, it wouldn't be difficult at all for her to get laid by, you know, dozens of guys in one day without even telling them that she did something with someone else previously. I mean, she just has to jump around, go to a few different bars. She can get laid every time she goes to a bar. She can get laid without going to a bar. She can get laid by going to the mall. She can get laid by going to CVS or Arbor Drugstore or whatever. But a man is not as easy. Can it happen? Yeah, a man can get laid that easy, but they will respect the man more because it's a more difficult feat. Like, oh man, he did that. Cool. A girl sleeps with 10 guys, you just look at her like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Close your goddamn legs. And that's really why I see the difference. As far as being sexually liberated, I think that's a bunch of crap. There's nothing wrong with being comfortable with your body, and I feel like that's what being sexually liberated is more about. And that's fine, but just the fact that, oh, I sleep with a bunch of guys because I'm sexually liberated, I'm not a hoe, that's garbage to my opinion. And even guys should respect themselves enough not to, you know, jump from woman to woman. But if that's what they need to make them feel better, I think that's just as self-conscious as a guy who, you know, only wants to date you know, a girl who hasn't been with a bunch of guys because he doesn't feel like he's up to snuff. You know, people see that as, you know, different things. But now the double standard seems more on men, because if, you know, a guy doesn't accept a woman for whatever she wants to be, or, you know, accept her for however she feels like being, and doesn't get mad at her past, or doesn't get mad at the kind of person she is, or doesn't accept her for every single little flaw she has, then that guy's a bad guy. But if it's the other way around, then it's like more power to the woman for not accepting him for, you know, being a loser, or not accepting him for not having enough money, or not accepting him because he has hair on his chest or doesn't have hair on his chest. You know, I just think the whole thing is just stupid, because now it's the double standard. There's going to be a double standard no matter what, because men and women aren't the same. We're not the same people. It's bad to compare men and women, because, I mean, you're just never going to get on the same playing field. I read something earlier about, like, if a guy slaps a woman, he's a monster. If a girl slaps a man, it's just, you know, a bad fight. And I agree with that. I don't think men should hit women. And yes, that's a double standard, but that's just life. Men aren't women. Men are more stronger than women. And why? Because we just bigger. We're born bigger. And if a guy hits a girl, she's smaller than him. What's so impressive about that? But if a girl beats up a guy, they're like, damn, And that's exactly what I mean. No one respects you for doing something that's unimpressive. You know, it's just there's no point in it. And if it's unimpressive, then there's where the double standard kicks in. It's not really a double standard, it's just the fact that, you know, women have gotten a lot of power. It's going to their heads. They don't have as much in this society as men do. They get graded on dumber things, but at the same time, they have more opportunities. For everything you don't have, you have something else. And, you know, it works itself out. Now, I'm not saying that everything's always fair, and there are things where women could, you know, lack in, but in this society that we, you know, deprive them of, but there are also things that men lack in that women can get. You know, a lot of things, especially falling on the terms of child custody. You know, there are a lot of bad mothers who have their kids, and there are a lot of good fathers who aren't, you know, who've had their kids taken away from them just because they saw fit that the woman should have more rights with the kid. I don't have any kids, so, but I see it every day, and it's just it annoys me. And I mean, no one preaches about the double standards about that much, and it's like everybody takes the woman's side. I saw a documentary. That sounds stupid, on vaginas the other day, and I agree that, you know, all these women were in Britain. I don't remember the name of the documentary. All the women in Britain were getting labiaplasty, I believe it's called, to make their vaginas look more regular, and they didn't notice that their vaginas, you know, every girl's vagina looks different, just like every guy's penis looks different, and they're not used to seeing that. And because they don't look at girls' vaginas, or they look at the ones in porn that are like really done up, and they think theirs aren't as nice. Now, some of the vaginas on that show, I will admit, I saw the couple ones that weren't very pretty, but they were the ones, I think, one or two that plastic surgeon showed to prove his point. Like, he showed the worst of the worst. All the other ones looked fine. There's nothing that would disgust me. But what upset me about the show was that there was a man. She went to go ask the two painters what they thought about a girl's vagina should, not if they should get plastic surgery, but does it is it important if the vagina looks nice? And the guy said yes, because I like eating girls out, or I like giving oral sex and receiving oral sex. And it's like, if you go down there and you try to want to eat a girl and it doesn't look very nice, you're going to lose your appetite. You know, it's like if you had slop on a plate instead of a nicely presented dish, you lose your appetite. That was his opinion, but she was automatically, you know, put down his opinion because she said you should accept, you know, in her opinion, you should accept a woman for whatever she looks like, and she automatically wanted to, you know, down the way his penis looked, even though she didn't see his penis, just have him pull down his pants so she can make fun of his penis. What if his penis looked nice? I mean, not saying that was the point. My point is that is the reason these girls are doing it, because people feel this way. You can't have your opinion, you know, and have the opinion that everybody should feel like you, or that everybody feels the way you do. And once you come across, you know, something that doesn't agree with what you do, that you just down it. And that's the same thing that's going on with that double standard with women and men. You know, there's a reason men and women, you know, women are hoes and men aren't. And as soon as anybody brings up the opposite idea, like why women should be hoes and men aren't, it's automatically put down because everybody's in favor of, you know, pretty much women being whatever they want to be, which is nothing wrong with that. But you know, if you are something, you are something. If you're not, you're not. It's just all it is. People, it bugs me when people want to do something and then don't soak up the title or soak up, you know, what came along with it. If you know, you kill somebody, you're a murderer. You don't, you know, change your mind. You can't change your mind about doing it and not be a murderer anymore. You know, you commit a felony, you're a felon. That's what you are. If you fuck a bunch of people, you're a hoe. That's all you are, man or woman. It doesn't matter. But as far as whether guys get praised for it or not, I mean, it's more difficult to fuck about. Now, if you fuck a bunch of women that don't look very good, okay, there's nothing special about that. So, there's, you know, he's still just as dirty of a hoe as a woman is who has sex with every guy that comes around her. So, I'm just explaining why, my opinion. No one has to agree with it, and I'm sure that everybody's going to hate me saying it, but that's what I think. All right. Signing out.